Sunday, everyone. I didn't get to finish videotaping last night or vlogging because my battery, actually it wasn't my battery, my phone ran out of room. So I wasn't able to finish telling you guys how everything went, but we ended up eating at a really nice restaurant called The Screen Door, and they had really good fried chicken and just really good food. So it was fun. It was a very southerny type cuisine, so that was good. And then we went to a comedy show because that's what I had given Austin as his gift for our anniversary part of it. So we went to that, and that was all right. The comedian was pretty good. He was funny. He's been on like Comedy Central and stuff. So, and then we went after that. We just actually drove back to the hotel and went to sleep. We were pretty exhausted, but. Now today we had breakfast at our hotel because they offer it, but it was actually pretty terrible. All they had was waffles and bread, and they had cereal, but everything was either out or had just like a little bit, like the syrup was like that much they had left. So we made the best of it though. And then we went to IKEA. We were looking for some stuff for the baby's room, and we did get some stuff, so I'll have to show that to you guys later. But we didn't get all of it, so we're gonna have to keep looking for some of those things. And then we just popped into Marshall's because we had some time to kill. We're meeting Austin's sister and niece and nephew for lunch, and then we're gonna continue shopping. So. It's kind of what our day has been so far, but yeah, just thanking the Lord for the money to buy these things and just to prepare for our little girl, because it's a lot, but it's all coming together. Hey everyone, we're back from our trip and we made it back safely, so we're thankful but tired. I just did some cleaning, just tried to clean up the kitchen and the dining room so that I don't have to do that tomorrow. And I just wanted to show you guys what we got. We ended up getting a good chunk of what we wanted to get while we were in Portland. So I'll show you guys what we got. Starting with IKEA. Let's see. At IKEA, we got... I just got a couple more picture frames to go in our living room because I want to get some of our maternity photos in there. So I got those. And then, this is for the baby's room. It's one of those awesome, floor lamps. And it has a really nice warm tone. It's like a night neutral, so it'll be really nice for like, the middle of the night when I'm coming in here to nurse. Instead of turning on, like, the bright light, it'll just be that nice soft lamp. And then, let's see, oh, I also got these storage containers because I'm going to put them here on the changing table. So I'll line them up right there and put like clothes or diapers in there. And then I'll probably take this basket and empty it and rearrange it as well. Let's see. So we spent about $70 at IKEA just with everything. These light bulbs that we got for the lamp were like $7 each, and you had to use three, which is expensive, but they're supposed to last 18 years. So I'm like, well, that's not bad. So got those. The other thing I got at IKEA that I was excited about was this pot lid organizer. I really have been wanting one of these and remembered that they had them at IKEA, so we got that today, which was awesome. We then went to a store in Portland that has secondhand things, and as you can see, I got a changing pad cover for the changing table, and it's really soft, and I think it looks pretty good against the beautiful painting that my sister-in-law did for me on that wall. So I haven't put everything together, but I wanted to put this on because I wanted to see what it looked like. I was really curious about that. So got that. Also got this adorable little shirt for her. This is a newborn shirt, so this is really cute. She can wear that with some little pants. And that was only $1. And then I got this cute little pajamas. I don't have a lot of newborn pajama stuff, so I got this, and I like it because you can cover her little hands. So you can just flip this over. Come on. It's easier with two hands. And keep her little hands warm. And it has this type of a bottom, so it'll be really easy to, you know, change her diaper in the middle of the night or whatever needs to be done. That one was like $3, I think. And it's really good shape, obviously, and I think it's Carter's. What's the brand? Well, it doesn't say it right there, but yeah, that's Carter's on there. So it was really cute. And then I got this car seat cover. It's called a car seat canopy, and so it's in really good condition. It's kind of a fun pattern, and it's really soft over here with the little bumps. It's got a pretty texture. It's not reversible, but it just looks cool. So that'll be nice to cover the car seat when we need to keep her warm and as we're transporting her places. So that's one thing that I need to work on, is getting the car seat in the car. And I think the last week of this month, I'm gonna take it to the fire station and they're gonna inspect it to make sure that we did it right. So that. And then also got her these little pajamas because they were on clearance, and they say Daddy's Sweetie on there. But they don't have the little hand things, but they do have her feet covered. So I like those. And this is 3 months. So look at that. So cute. And then we also got, Austin was like so excited about this. He was like, you have to get one of these. So it's one of those jumpers that you hang on the door. It's called Jenny Jump Up. And you just hang it in the door and she can, you know, just start bouncing her little legs and get her little energy out and have fun at the same time. So that was a cool find, and it's Even Flow, so it's a good brand. And then we also got a diaper wipes warmer. So that's another thing that I really wanted. And we got this one. So yeah, found a lot of good stuff. We only spent, I think, about $30 there, and we got a bunch of stuff. So I'm excited to put it all together and just make the final touches, you know, in this room. We didn't get a rug, which I was really hoping to get, but there's a few stores around here, you know, in Bend, that I can probably find something that'll work. So I will have to try that probably this week or this weekend and get a rug in here. So I'm excited to show you guys when it's all done. It's gonna look beautiful. Hey everybody, it's Monday and I survived 8 hours of work. It was kind of a long day. Our phones were down for half the day because someone crashed into the phone pole. So we didn't have calls for half the day, which is kind of nice, but then it's also hard because then you can't really call your clients that you need to call. But today I'm just feeling especially pregnant. My back's been hurting, and then I feel like the baby's moving down more because I just feel some like more pelvic pain and pressure than I did before. And I know I'm gonna see the chiropractor, not this Wednesday, but next Wednesday. And so that'll be good because last time I was there, he was telling me that my hips were off balance and he wasn't able to quite get them rebalanced. So I think I'm feeling that too. But anyways, I'm sitting here. Monday, it's Monday, you know that. But since we were gone, I have to go grocery shopping tonight. So I'm trying to put together my list. And I have about 4 dinners to prepare for. So I'm just gonna kind of show you my routine as I go along. But I typically have 3 things. I'll show you. First thing I have is my groceries meal planner. So I can record, you know, what I need. And then over here is where I write what meals we're having. The other item I have is, this is a Taste of Home magazine. And so I use this for making meals as well. And I always write like if it's good, like this was what I made last week, that curried cream sauce. And so I'll just mark in here if it's good or if it's not good. Just a bunch of different recipes. So I always use this, and it goes by months, which is kind of nice because then it has seasonal food in there. So in August, I'll start using the August one. This obviously is a year old, but I still use it because I don't have a new subscription, so I just use this one. And the other item is my phone, which I'm using to record, so I don't need to show you that. But I use that to look up recipes on Pinterest and just recipes on allrecipes.com just to find things that are good. I also will use the Clean Eating website because they have some recipes as well, but their magazine issue this month was vegetarian, and Austin has to have meat, you know, for dinner. So I haven't been using any of their dinner recipes, but I've been using their lunch recipes for me as well as their snack ideas. So I'm gonna get to work on this and I'll show you guys once I'm all done. Hi everybody. I tried vlogging in the car again on my way back from the store, Walmart, but I just can't get my I can't think of what it's called, but it's like what holds your phone onto your dashboard. I can't get it to stick. I need to clean it off because it just falls off and then I'm like a traffic hazard. So it's not worth the risk. So I just stopped and waited till I got home. But I just ended up, I only needed about 4 nights worth of menus and I didn't. It's not 100% clean, like I said. I'm not really sticking to that. I just try to make healthy stuff and make good things. And so my clean eating this week is mostly just for my lunches. So for breakfast, I'm doing cream of wheat cereal. And then for lunch, I'm going to do, it's like a peanut butter sandwich, but it has slices of strawberries in it. And then a peach and a carrot. And then for my snack, I'm going to have crackers with hummus, left over from last week. And then for dinners, I got some chicken and some pork chops. So we'll do pork chop with a glaze and, you know, some sort of side, whether it's potatoes or rice. I have brown rice. And then chicken, I'm going to be doing this recipe. It's like spinach artichoke chicken pasta. And it's really yummy, and Austin likes it. And he doesn't normally like spinach, but he does like this recipe. So I'm going to do that this week. And then the other one, I don't have my list in front of me, so I'm sorry. I'm going to do balsamic chicken with couscous. And I made that once before, and the couscous is really good because you add chicken broth to it, and it's so delicious. And then last time I forgot to, like, totally make the balsamic chicken. I just made plain chicken and it was still really good. So this time I'm going to actually follow the recipe and do the balsamic glaze. So that's going to be tasty. I think that's it. I always have weird interactions at stores. I don't know why. But the cashier guy, he was older, and he said, he asked me to do something, and I was like, I didn't hear him, so I asked him, you know, what he said. And then he said, oh, I asked you just to sign here for my bill. And so I started to sign, and he was like, do you think I could be a radio DJ? And I was like, and he's like, oh, well, some people tell me that I have, like, a DJ voice, so. And I was like, well, I don't know. I wasn't thinking that. I think because I asked him what he said, he thought about his voice and how he says things. I'm not sure. But poor Walmart cashier guy. All he wants to be is a DJ. A radio DJ. But anyways, that was kind of funny. And today I bought some newborn diapers. And they are so cute. I'll show you. They're just these tiny little things. Like, that's like the size of my hand. And there's the back. My hand looks all red. It's like irritated. More pregnancy symptoms, I guess. But yeah. So I got a pack of newborn diapers. Because I don't know how long she's going to be in this size. So I just got one of the smaller packs. And I've heard that Pampers Swaddler. I always hear good things about Pampers Swaddler. So that's what I went with. And by the way, I am in the baby's room right now. And this is obviously her crib. And I found this cool tree branch idea on Pinterest. And for my baby shower, my mom actually made it as part of the decorations. And then there's a sign over there that says, she is more precious than rubies, Proverbs 3:15. And that's another thing I saw on Pinterest that I liked and my mom made for me. So my mom's very artistic. So yeah, I look forward to showing you guys the room when everything's all set up, but I just didn't have time to do anything else tonight. I just came home, made dinner, took a little nap and relaxed a little bit because I was pretty wiped out, and then did my grocery list and then went grocery shopping, and I just got back. So I also had to do some shopping for my brother because it's his birthday on Wednesday. So that's kind of been the night, but I'm just going to relax now, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Okay, so dinner is done and it's Tuesday night. I made tonight the couscous, and then the balsamic chicken glaze, and then just some corn that's organic, and it's from Costco. It's really good corn. I like using that corn. This time I didn't forget the glaze. It's not the most prettiest display, but I haven't tasted it yet, but it looks really good. And then the couscous, you make by putting chicken broth in it and garlic powder and pepper. And I really like the couscous. It's very moist and has a really good flavor. It tastes better than when you just add water, probably because of the chicken broth, obviously. But yeah, so we're gonna dig in here and I'll tell you guys about the rest of my day here soon. All right, so dinner turned out to be really good. The chicken was really good with the glaze, and mine was a little too salty, but everything else tasted really good, so that turned out well. I was going to tell you guys that today I got a pedicure done through work, and it was very needed. I wanted to get one anyways before I had the baby, so this was a little sweet treat. I ended up doing like a, it's called a lava, no, it was called Go With The Flow, Go With The Lava Flow. So it's kind of like a reddish pink with some sparkle. So that's fun. I haven't really told you guys what I do yet, but I'm actually an insurance agent. So I'm an independent insurance agent, and I've been doing that for 3 years now. So it's definitely been interesting with the whole Obamacare change, and it's, I kind of came into it at a good time though, because I didn't have like a lot of rules or things memorized, so I could come in and just learn it and just kind of go with the flow. So it's been interesting. If you guys have any questions, you can put it in the comments. And now I'm gonna get lunches ready for tomorrow, and it's almost the end of our day. Hello, it's Wednesday and it feels like Friday because we're going to a birthday party. It's my brother's birthday today, so we're heading out to my parents' house to celebrate his birthday. He is turning 35, so he is 11 years older than me. Hey everybody, it's Thursday, and I have to say I'm really sorry about yesterday. My phone ran out of memory, and so I had to take off a bunch of videos in order to record. And I didn't know that yesterday. And so my clip was like 30 seconds. But it was a really good birthday party. He had chosen a, I think it was called lime cilantro chicken tacos or something like that. But whatever it was very delicious. My mom is a super good cook, so she did a great job of cooking that meal, and we had a good time just hanging out and opening up gifts. And we had cupcakes for his birthday, and as like his birthday cake, and we just ended up hanging out, so it was a good time. But I'm sorry I didn't get really much footage from that. So today I am just sitting here cooking some dinner. I'm making grilled. Well, let me see here. It's called grilled bourbon chops. Grilled bourbon chops. Like a dog. But I just substituted the bourbon for apple juice. And so what you do is you grill your pork chops. So I'll show you guys that. There's the pork chops. And then the sauce is right over here. And it's got mustard in it and garlic, and just creates a really yummy sauce. So I gotta wait for this to boil so that it will become like a sauce. Oh, sorry if that was loud. Oops. There we go. And then these are some mashed potatoes. That I'm gonna cook up. So that's gonna be tasty. And I'm gonna switch this. So I'm cooking dinner, and after that I need to go to the store. I have a baby shower to go to this weekend, so I'm gonna go get the gift. That way I don't have to rush tomorrow, because tomorrow's gonna be a really busy day. And then I'll have it for Saturday morning.
What's the put?
I promise this isn't a food vlog, but this is so good. Look at that. Look at that dinner. So we got the pork chops with the sauce, mashed potatoes, salad with cucumbers and red peppers and some feta cheese, some plain old bread. So I'm gonna dig in, but I just wanted to show you guys.
It's good.
Oops, I think I just made a big error. I was ironing my shirt and I set my iron down and quickly texted something simple to a friend, and I just went back and lifted up the iron, and this is what I saw. See that iron imprint? Oops. I'm not sure if that shirt's gonna be wearable now. Seems like it's fading, but I'm not sure. So I'm gonna give it some time and hope for the best. So I decided not to go to the store tonight. I'm just gonna go to a different baby store tomorrow and pick up a gift for my friend, because I have half day tomorrow, and I'll just include that in it. I just got done reading my Bible, and I've been really encouraged lately. I feel like there's definitely a theme that's been going on. Toby thinks I'm talking to him, so he's all excited. Hi, Toby. But the other day I was reading about how they were talking about, do you have a spirit of complaining, or do you have a spirit of thankfulness? And if you have a spirit of complaining, it's almost like you're complaining because you think that you deserve all these things that you want, you know, and that's not how it is, or how it should be. You know, we should have a spirit of thankfulness, and there's so much to be thankful for every day. You know, it's just even the little things that we might not think are a big deal, it really is, because we are so blessed here, especially in America. And you know, we take for granted way too much. So I've just been thinking about that a lot lately, and I'm reading in Job right now, and he talks about how our life is but a shadow on this earth. Job chapter 8, if you want to find that verse. It's Job chapter 8, verse 9. And it says, "For we are but of yesterday, and know nothing, because of our days upon earth are a shadow." So it's just like, you know, this life is important, and we have a mission while we're here, but it's so fleeting. You know, it's going to go by just like that, and then we get to spend eternity with our Father, so, in heaven. And that's just something that I think people forget a lot, is that this is not our home. You know, we're here for a time, and there's great things that happen here on earth, and there's really terrible things that happen here on earth, but the end goal is heaven and what we can do to further the kingdom for Christ and what we can do for Christ. So it's just a good reminder. Toby's really cute. He's looking at me. You want to say hi? You want to say hi? See Toby? Toby? Toby, look this way. He hasn't quite gotten the hang of blogging yet. Look here, Toby. No, don't bark. Silly, that's you. That's you. Anyways, I'll have to see how my shirt's doing. Hopefully I didn't burn too much of a hole in it. Alright, well, I'm gonna just finish up here. The baby's moving a lot, so it's nice to just sit back and relax. I would show you guys, but my dress is really distracting because of the print, so it'd probably be hard to see where she's actually moving. But only 4 weeks to go. It's so crazy. That's what I was going to announce yesterday, is that, like, yeah, it's only 4 weeks. She's going to be here in 4 weeks or less, hopefully. I guess unless she's late, and then the max they let you go is like 2 weeks before they induce you. But it's so exciting. I finished building the light tonight in her room, but I'm not going to show you guys until I have it more put together, because I'd like to show you guys the finished product, so I'll show you guys that later. Hey guys, here's Deacon. Gonna get him all brushed and groomed for his vet appointment. Hey guy. Okay guys, here's Deacon. Poor guy. He's really sedated. He got his teeth floated, which they needed to do. But otherwise, she said he's in really good condition. Poor guy. He's bleeding a little bit there where they gave him his shot, but I just had to go get him some water. Anyways, here's my little boy. Good boy, Deacon. He has to be in here for about an hour before he can safely go out with the other horses, because he's pretty sedated. So I gotta go to my doctor's appointment now, but I had to go grab him some water, which took me forever, which I will explain in the next video. Hey, it's Friday night and we just got done eating dinner. We went out to a Mediterranean restaurant and
it's really good.
Now we're just looking at the baby car seats, because we have to get it installed this weekend, because on Wednesday I'm going to go to the firehouse and have them inspected to make sure that we have it in my car right, so that way we're ready when the baby comes.
Took us about 15 minutes to figure out just how to get this off.
Yeah, it's a Chico Keyfit 30, so
it's all
really
cute.
Stuff. And
it's really handy.
It's good up to. Can you be careful, please?
Yeah.
It's good up to 30 pounds, and as you can see, look how tiny these little things are. She's just gonna fit right in there, and then we'll get something different for when she grows up and gets bigger.
Finally figured out how to get the little visor on there. My wife's so smart. I tried to get the thing just off of this little thing here, and it took me like 5 minutes, maybe 10 minutes, and still couldn't get it off. And of course, being a man, I didn't look at the directions. She got it off in about 10 seconds.
It doesn't come down very easily, but
I wonder if that's just...
Maybe it's just supposed to stay mostly like this, yeah, like, but the problem is it's just not very easy. Well, I guess that's fine.
It's so everything wraps around it, I guess. It looks really comfortable, though, and super safe, because there's even a level on it.
It's actually pretty light, too, but
yeah.
I'm going to have to get used to, like, little baby in here that's gonna weigh hopefully like 7 pounds or less, and then have my diaper bag too. And then I got the car seat cover, so that like when it's rainy outside or if it's really sunny, I can just put this on.
Oh.
And
it tapes on there?
Doesn't tape.
It's Velcro's? Is it made for it?
Yeah,
Or is it for anyone?
I guess it's a car seat canopy.
Good idea. How did you get that? Did we get that from the baby shower?
No, we got this when we went to
Portland.
I told you we got it.
Oh.
Obviously, what?
I didn't know what it was for, obviously.
So, and then if someone's like, hey, I want to see your cute baby, you can just be like, oh yeah? There she is.
Wait. If somebody says that to me, I'll just point at you.
Yeah, the other one.
The other one. She's not here. But if you look, this thing is so technically advanced and safe. It has a level to make sure that you put your baby seat in level so that the baby doesn't get hurt.
Okay, so I think we got it figured out. We're just using the installation using the vehicle belt. And as you can see, oops, it's not quite level. Have to adjust it. Yeah. You have to kind of push it back against the seat there. That way it's level. And then put the shoulder strap through.
Well, we got it in.
Okay, so I've already shown them this, but I just strap it in. And so I'm gonna put this, well, I'm not done reading this, but I'm going to put this eventually in this little storage box.
Okay.
And right in here.
Just snaps right in there.
And click, and it says to always pull up. Hey guys, so we got a lot of footage today. Anyways, we got a lot of footage today, but I was gonna tell you guys that Deacon's vet appointment overall went well. He hates anything going in his mouth though, so when they do the floating, the teeth floating, they have to sedate them, and so they sedated him, and he was like really drowsy, but even still he was not happy. And when they got to one area, he like totally pulled back and started backing way up, so we had to like stop everything. And they had to give him more sedation because he wasn't going for it. So poor guy, he was just like really he did not have a good day today, but the vet was really kind and gentle with him. It's just he doesn't like to have that done, which I don't blame him. But so they got his teeth floated. He did have an ulcer in there, they said, that was really small and wasn't really, she didn't think that was causing him to do like all the drooling, but it was definitely time to get his teeth floated. So I had to leave him in the stall because he couldn't be with the other horses because he was sedated and he also couldn't eat. And so I wanted to get him water before I left, but I also needed to hurry because I needed to get to my, you know, doctor's appointment. Look how pretty these holly hoops are in Mom's house. They're almost to the top of the roof. So pretty. Hey guys, it is now Saturday and it's like 6:45. I'm just cooking some dinner. Tonight I'm making it's called cheesy bow tie chicken. So it's like a chicken and pasta dish, and you use spinach and artichoke cheese dip as like the sauce. So super yummy. Probably not the healthiest, but it's easy to make and it's really delicious. And it's okay to have splurges every now and then. So I'm making that, and this morning I went to a baby shower of a friend, and so that was fun. She's actually due one day after me, so it's always fun to kind of talk about what symptoms we're feeling. And it's not so loud. And then after that, I went and hung out with my mom. I took a little clip of her courtyard. It's so pretty with all those flowers. So you guys will get to see that. And then came home and just cleaned. I did go to TJ Maxx because I'm still looking for a rug for the baby's room. And they didn't really have anything. But I did go to their baby section and they had some clearance. And I got these. They're the baby's first year stickers. And they were only $4, so it's a good price on clearance. Drake, go on, go on, go on, buddy. But anyways, it's been a great day. I mean, I feel good. The house is pretty much clean for the week, so that's good. And then I'll do grocery shopping tomorrow and get that done. And so I also just need to work a little bit more on the baby's room, and I was talking to my mom today, and she's like, you really need to get your hospital bag packed. I'm like, I know. The only thing I have for it is chapstick, because that's easy to pick up, and so I got chapstick so far, but that's about it. So I'll have to pack that up. I also want to order my diaper bag this weekend, and I think I'm going to get it from Kohl's, because I have like a bunch, well, I have a gift certificate there, and I have a coupon, so probably gonna just make the most of that and order something there. I'm not like super thrilled with the bags that they have, but at the same time, I don't want to spend like a couple $100 on a diaper bag, because that's just, to me, it's not a good use of money for me anyways. But so I'll probably get that ordered, and then it'll be fun to show you guys once I'm all packed and show you what I got in my hospital bag. So that's kind of the agenda so far. Hope you guys have a great week ahead, and enjoy this week's video. Please be sure to subscribe and put your comments in. I really am hoping that you guys are enjoying these vlogs, but there hasn't been a ton of views yet, of course, because we're new. So just hang in with us and hang in there and enjoy. All right, thanks, guys.